I've been on a lot of soccer teams and I've had a lot of good coaches, but I don't think I've ever had a coach where everybody on the team, from the first to the last player, was entirely bought in, completely bought into the system, completely bought into the team. And it goes back to the fitness, the going out in those January sessions when it's snowing outside, and tailing outside. And to have that, especially when you've got a bunch of teenagers who don't want to listen to anybody, the fact that he was able to get all of those teenagers together and working in that common, towards that common goal in that one direction was, I think, really, really incredible. Lastly, I want to thank just the community as a whole, and that includes my teammates, that includes coaches I had before, that includes boosters, that includes supporters at games. It was really, really special, I think, to grow up in Camas, because I felt like everybody grew up playing, at least in my generation, everybody grew up playing soccer. They played a year or two, like my brother played soccer, I looked up to him, I looked up to his teammates, I looked up to the Downses, I looked up to so many families in this area. It was, I think, I don't know why the soccer was so special here, but I've noticed that in the last, I don't know how many of you are familiar with the club soccer formatting now. A lot of these high-level club teams, you're not allowed to play high school soccer anymore. You have to choose between one or the other, and I feel really, really grateful that I didn't have to make that choice because it was so special that I got to play with the guys in my community, the guys that I was playing with since 5 years old, Eric over here, Scotty, guys I had known my whole life. I got to do it. I got to go to war with them on the soccer field for my community, and that was really, really special to me. I know a lot of players that have come up and were playing club. They didn't get to do that with their high schools, and they say, oh, it wasn't that important. I was like, well, you didn't do it. You didn't know how special that was to win a championship with your teammates, with your friends that you've known your whole life. So I felt really, really thankful that I got to do that. And then lastly, you know, I was thinking about players that I looked up to, my people that inspired me, and that was, like I said, my brother. That was Danny Downs, that was Brad Downs, that was Scotty Downs, guys that were older than me, but also guys that I played with as well. Like he was talking about earlier, somebody mentioned Greg. I think Greg, I was looking at, I remember in high school, Mr. Rinder had a website where he had all the records from each team, and you would see these names like Daniel Carlson, Jonathan Carlson, Dan Mattia. I think Greg had 7 assists in one game, which was insane. And I always remember, I go to that website a lot, and I would say, I want to be like one of those guys. I want to be somebody that's on that list there that has 7 assists in a game or scores 31 goals in a season. And so to have those type of people in your community that you're looking up to was really, really special for me. And then also my other peers, I got to do a shout out to the 05 girls. They showed us how to do it. They were the ones that got the championship first. They really did. It was great. I got to manage with them. We got to become friends with them. It was really exciting to see them do that. And they showed us the ropes, and it was awesome. We did it the season after that. And so there's a lot of people that were an inspiration to me. And it was not just older people, but people that were my age as well, my peers, that I still look up to. And I guess that when I think about it, I just hope that I have been for others what those people have been for me. I'm just so thankful that I got to grow up in this community and play here. So thank you.